This is one of my favorite problem, and this problem includes both the screw friction concept as well as the wedge friction concept. And if I'll state the problem says that there is a wedge which tries to push the 0.3 ton block, and the wedge is pushed with the help of a screw which is supported by one stand, and we are applying a moment M at the top surface, top end of the screw, so that the screw will rotate, screw will come in the downward direction, it will pull the push the wedge, and because of the motion of the wedge, the block will move in the right side direction. And we have to find the value of M so that we can break the equilibrium, or we can push this block, where the wedge angle is given as 75 degree here. And this is the statement that the wedge A pressed downward through a screw by and the mean radius of the screw is given as 15 mm and the diameter and the lead is given as 20 mm. The coefficient of static friction between the screw is 0.2, as well as for all the other faces it is 0.2, and we have to find the value of M so that we can push this block towards right side. Now in this problem there are two sections, one section related to the wedge part, another section is related to the screw part, and we have to take care both the part. As we know that this aim is the ultimate goal, is getting aim is the ultimate goal, so we have to start our problem with the wedge problem. Once we will solve the wedge problem, we can get what is the force required here so that we can push this block. Once we will get this force is going to be used to get the value of M. So now the problem has two part. One part is related to screw. Here I am showing the screw part, and here you can see that if this is my screw connected with the nut, and we know that if there will be a force P at the end of the screw, and we want to push the screw against this force M, for that we need to apply a moment here. Basically we don't apply a moment here. What we do, if I'll see here, or if I'll see this in larger view, that suppose I'll see the top view of my screw. So this is the top view of my screw and this is the length of the screw. So what I will do, I will apply a tangential force F here, and because the rate, this F into R will basically becomes the moment on the screw. So what I need to find, I have to find this force. If I will multiply this force with R, I'll get the M value. And for a screw, I know the formula that if I want to push the screw again against a force P, so this is basically my load and this F is basically my effort, and the relation between the load and the effort is that F is equal to P tan phi plus alpha, where phi is calculated by the coefficient of friction. So this phi is nothing but the tan inverse phi mu will be my phi, where mu is the coefficient of friction between the nut and the screw. This is my nut part, this is my screw part. Alpha is the helix angle, which is basically shows the geometry of the screw, because these screw threads are moving in an helical path, and we have to find the helix angle, which can be identified by using this triangle. This triangle says that the perpendicular of the triangle will be lead, and the base of the triangle is basically pi d, where d is the 2 times of mean radius, which is given in the question. So the d will be 30 mm here, and when I will use this, I will be able to get the alpha value, which is coming out 11.2 degree, and when I am putting this 10 inverse 0.2, I am getting a phi, which is 11.3 degree. So now in this question, I know the alpha value, I know the phi value, I know when I will get the P value by solving the wedge part, I will be able to get the force part, and when I will get the force part, I can get the moment part. Now see the wedge part. In case of the wedge, if I'll see here that in the question that wedge is basically going to move in the downward direction, and when the wedge will move in the downward side, there are friction forces on the surface of the wedge as well as the frictional forces on the one surface of the block. As the block will move towards the right side, the ground will also apply a friction force. So first we have to identify different forces, direction of the forces on the wedge as well as block. So we know that the block is going to move towards the right. So let's start with the block, that if the block will move in this direction, there will be a friction force on the block from the ground. So this is the friction force from the ground. And at the same time, there will be normal reaction from the ground. The weight of the block will be 300 Newton if my G is 10 meter per second square. At the same time, if I'll see here, as the wedge is going in the downward direction, there will be a friction force between these two surfaces. The wedge is going in the downward direction. So this block will try to resist the wedge motion. So I have to first to find the force on this surface, and that would be in the upward direction. You cannot put the direction of friction force here in the downward side directly. First you have to think that what is happening with the wedge. Wedge is the driver member here. Basically wedge starts all the motion. So all the other surface will try to resist the motion of our wedge. In that case, this surface will try to resist the motion of the wedge. So it will be in the upward direction, and this would be the normal reaction here. Similarly, wedge is attached with this surface here. This is the surface of the wall. So the wall will also try to resist the motion of the wedge. So there will be again friction force on the surface of the wedge, and there will be a normal reaction here. At the same time, this would be the equal and opposite force. Suppose this is N, this would be N1. This is F1. So equal and opposite force F1 will act here. And there will be a force P here. So now I have identified different forces on the wedge surface as well as on the block surface. When I will write the equation of the equilibrium for these two members, I will be able to get the P value, which I am going to use here to get the M value. So now this here I am showing the two free body diagram, which just I explained that these are the free body diagram and these are the different forces. Now if I will write the equation for the force equilibrium for this block as well as this wedge, here are the equation for the block. You can see here that there are vertical force balance as well as horizontal force balance. So this is the equation for the vertical force balance. In vertical force balance, N1 is going to be balanced by the 3000 Newton force as well as the downward friction force, which will be mu N2. And the horizontal forces are going to be balanced by this N2 is going to be balanced by this frictional force, which will be nothing but the mu N1. When I am solving these two equations, I am getting that N1 and N2 are coming out 3125 Newton and 625 Newton. Now let's see the equations for the wedge part. So here I am having this is not the vertical direction. Basically there is a small 15 degree angle, because if I will see my problem, in the problem this angle is given as 75 degrees. So I can see that this vertical angle will be of 15 degree. Now when I will do the horizontal and vertical force balance, this is the equation for my horizontal force balance, that M3 will be having a horizontal force component and a vertical force component. So this horizontal force component will be basically, this is my alpha angle. So 15 cos N3 cos 15, the N2 is in the opposite direction, so minus N2. And as the same time, this force is also having two component, one will be in the vertical side and one will be in this side, and that component will be basically mu N3 sine alpha. So this is my first equation, which is representing the horizontal force balance, and the vertical force balance can be write as N3 sine 15, vertical component of this force, vertical component of this force as well as this force. These three forces are going to be balanced with the P. So this is my equation 1 and 2, and this is my equation 3 and 4. So when I will solve these two equation using these two value, I am getting that N3 is coming out 683.68 Newton and P is coming out 434. So now let's go back and check that I have calculated this P value. So now I can apply this P value in this formula, so I'll get the F value. So here is your P force, and you have to find the M force. As you know that F is going to be balanced by P10 alpha plus phi, and I can write that F is the moment by radius, because when I will see the top view, this is the force basically, which is my effort, and this is the mean radius. So the moment ultimately is going to be F into R. So here is the formula for the moment, and I know that the alpha is 11.2 degree and phi is 11.3 degree. When I will put all the value together, I am getting that my moment is coming out 2696.5 Newton mm. So now let's summarize the problem, that if I will apply a moment of magnitude 26, 96.5 Newton per millimeter, I will be able to break the equilibrium of this system, and the wedge will go in the downward direction and it will ultimately push this block towards the right. In the question, if you will see, the weight or the mass of the block is given in ton unit. So 1 ton is basically 1000 kilogram. You should remember this part. And therefore, I have considered the mass of the block as 300 grams. Okay, thank you.